Hello everyone and welcome to my channel. In today's video, I am going to be testing out the Beetles nail tips and glue set. If you are interested to see how I do and what I come up with and what I think about it, then keep on watching. Alright, so opening it up, this is what it comes with. So we do have an application guide telling us how to use the product. Then we have some nail tips, and I believe these are coffin nail tips. So there's a whole bag of those. And then we have one bottle of the nail glue, which is, I'm assuming, the nail gel. And then it does also come with a lamp. I actually don't have a lamp like this, so I'm interested to see how this goes. All right, and this is the nail lamp, just like that, just a regular looking nail lamp. So the wire isn't super long. It's really not that long, so I don't know how I'm going to set this up. But let me just go ahead and set this lamp up and I'll be right back. All right, so I have the little lamp plugged in and I assume we just press, oh, okay, wait a second. Okay, so it's on, but I don't think you can turn it off, so it just kind of turns on. It does have four little bulbs right here, so it is quite a strong little guy. So I'm just gonna put this onto the side. So I am gonna go in and size my nails out. So it does come with a bunch of little nail baggies. I would have preferred if they came in little like a little box, but I guess this is just a lot more compact and it's such a small box it comes in. So I'm just gonna go ahead and size out my nails. So yeah, 10 being the smallest. So let's just get in here and get some pinky nails out. All right, so these are quite long. They are like a long coffin, which is interesting. Also, I am not going to be cutting my nails down because I do want to grow out my natural nails, which is why I love this kind of system. So they don't really have a high apex. Like, there's not a lot of gap in between, so we won't really need to fill that up. But they are quite sturdy. They are a lot more flimsier on, like quite a lot flimsier on the cuticle, but the tip of it is not, so that's amazing. So I'm just gonna go ahead and size out all of my nails. All right, so I have all of my nail tips sized out. I have super, super tiny nails, so these are very tiny. They did seem like they fit quite nicely, but so my nails are already prepped because I had just removed a previous set. So we're just going to go ahead into the instructions. So I'm gonna go into the application guide and see what it tells me to do. So the first thing it says is file and shape and buff the nails. It is not included in the kit, so you do have to use your own. Then we will cleanse the nails. We already are gonna choose the proper size. Then we just take the appropriate amount of nail glue gel and apply it on the false nail tip and then place it. So it doesn't tell us to do it like the Apres way. We don't have to apply anything on to our nails. So we just will go right into the application. We're just gonna go straight into the nail glue and put it onto the tips first. I am going to go ahead and apply a quick layer of peel off gel on my nails first. So that is what's going to be the shiny layer, but it is not going to be the nail glue. We will use the nail glue just to attach the nails. So I'm going to go ahead and put my little base gel on. So for my peel off base, I like to use this one from Jellyfit. So I'm just going to go ahead and apply a layer of that on all of my nails. All right, so after I have my little peel off coat on, I am going to go in with the nail glue. So for this, it didn't say that I have to buff the nail or anything like that. So I am just going to follow the directions and hope for the best, because I would usually buff the bottom of this. But since the instructions for this said that you don't need to, I am not going to. I will follow the instructions just as they say. So I'm going to take some of this gel. So it does seem like a quite thin gel actually compared to the Apres one. Again, I am going to be comparing it with the Apres one a lot because that's the only one I have tried. But this one is a lot thinner of a consistency than the Apres one for sure. So I'm just gonna go ahead and now place it on my pinky. It's quite liquidy actually, so I'm concerned of how it's going to go. So let's just say a prayer and go in. I'm gonna apply it just like I would with the Apres. Okay, I need a little bit more gel in there. Actually, no, we can get it. Okay, and once I have that, I can place it in here. Okay, so I'm actually going to turn my lamp on first because otherwise it's way too difficult to do that. So I'm just gonna go in and cure. Okay, so super easy, wasn't too difficult. This is my first time using a lamp like this and it's actually quite easy. Wow, I really like that. Okay, I'm just gonna fully cure that. All right, and that's what that looks like. I think it's actually quite nice. I actually really like the apex on that as well, and I think it looks pretty good. I did get some spillage, but that's okay. We will clean that up, but super easy to use. So I do recommend to just turn the lamp on first and then continue that way. So I'm just going to apply another little bit on this nail now, and this time I am going to use a little bit more of that. And honestly, they feel very sturdy. Turn my lamp on and let's see. Very nice. And it actually doesn't feel like it's like really, ooh, never mind. I was speaking way too soon. It does kind of burn, but not too bad. And just keep in mind that because I do have this little protective layer of gel on my nails, that could be helping the heat spikes. So I'm not too sure what it would be like without any layer. I think it might be quite severe if you have thinned out nails. But really pretty nonetheless. I think they're turning out quite nice. I'm liking the way that they look so far. All right, so after I applied them, I did go ahead and cure this in my big UV lamp just to make sure that they're fully cured. And they look so good. The next step that it says is that I can clip the nails and then shape them to my desired length. But I think I'm gonna keep this length. I really like it and they feel really sturdy, like they're on there, which is honestly, obviously what we wanted. So I really like them. I think the apex is perfect on them. They look beautiful, super easy to use. It is a little bit on the thinner side, so I did feel like it has a little bit more air bubbles than I would usually get with like the Apres stuff, but I'm gonna go ahead now and let's file them and see how they file. So I'm just taking a 100 grit file and just going to shape these sides, making sure that my side walls are lined up and make sure that they're nice and straight. Look at that, they look so good. And honestly, this process was so much quicker than the Apres process. I feel like I did this quite quick. Also, I'm super sorry if you can hear some background noise. It is so windy outside and it is pouring rain. So, super sorry for that. But these are quite long actually. We'll see how we feel about the length once we're done shaping and filing. Okay, so the next thing after I file them and shape them, I'm just gonna go ahead with my nail file and file towards the cuticle just to make sure that those are nice and flush to my cuticle. So once they grow out fairly nice. So I'm just gonna quickly do that. And again, if I have any spill, if I do have any gel seepage or whatever, that will also help. Just take it off and remove it. So I'm just gonna go around my cuticles with my nail file and just, you know, clean it up a bit. The next step in the pamphlet it comes with does say that you are ready to polish. I am not going to polish it on such a slippery surface, so I am gonna go ahead and buff them because obviously I want my polish to stay, and I know that it's not going to stay if I don't buff them. So I'm just gonna take a buffing block very quickly and just lightly buff over my nails, making sure that they are nice and matte, free of any shine. If you find that your nail polish is chipping or your gel polish is chipping using this kit, then I do definitely recommend to go in and buff your nails before, because it does skip out on that step. And we definitely don't want to skip out on this step. It's crucial to making sure that your nail polish or your gel polish is going to last. After I'm done shaping and buffing and filing and all that stuff, I am going to go ahead and grab a brush and put some alcohol on it and wipe my nails. So I'm just going to make sure that all of the dust is off of my nails, and now that they are nice and dehydrated and ready to paint. So for today's nail look, I do want to do some glass nails. I haven't ever done glass nails, so I'm super excited. And I want to do them in like French glass nails. I've been seeing this literally everywhere. So there is numbers underneath the nail tip, so I'm actually not too sure how well this is going to work. So let's just see. Otherwise, we are going to go in and file the numbers out. All right, so for this nail look, we are going to be doing a French glass looking nail. So I'm gonna go in with a base color. I'm not too sure how I'm going to do this, but I have a little idea in my head, so hopefully we can execute it. So I'm going to take a neutral nude base for my French, of course, making sure that I'm getting really into my cuticles. So that's my base color. And then I am going to bring it as high as I want, like probably up to here, making sure obviously that my natural nails are covered. Yeah, I like that. Then I am going to go in with a poly gel brush, is what I'm thinking might work the best, and some alcohol. So I just have some alcohol in my dampened dish right here. And I am going to then try to carve this French out. I'm not too sure how well this plan is going to work, but in my head it works. So let's see. So I'm going to take that brush and I'm going to try my best to, yeah, that works, to clean up the smile line. Once I'm happy with that, I'm going to go ahead and cure, just a flash cure, then we're going to do a second coat. Right, and once I have that, I'm gonna go in with my base color again and do a nice second coat. This time I'm gonna try my best to carve it. Perfect. And then next we're just gonna have to clean up just a little bit, but that should be good. Okay, we're just gonna go ahead and cure once you're happy with that. And I'm just gonna go ahead and repeat this for rest of my nails. All right, so I did go ahead and do like a French like smile line on all of the nails. So the next thing I'm going to do, because it makes sense in my head, is I'm going to go ahead and top coat these with a no wipe top coat, and I'm hoping that comes out and turns out the way I want it to. So my hands look super dry right now. Oh yeah, that's beautiful. Okay, so you guys see what I'm trying to do is like I'm getting like this glass finished. That's what I want. So I'm just going to top coat this and then cure that. So the next thing I'm going to do is grab some white nail polish and we are going to try to make a nice French cut with this. And I'm using white for this because we are going to be using pigments, or that's the plan. So I don't know if you can really see that. Okay. And then I'm also going to apply some on the tip. I'm going to try very strategically, try to place a thick enough line just so I cover that number from the bottom. We're going to connect the sides. All right, so now I have all of my French nails framed. I am then Next, going to take some pigments. These pigments are from Amazon. I haven't really used them too much, so I'm not too sure how they are. So I'm going to hope that they work really well, because this is why I did the white base. So I did it on a nice glossy top coat. That way these are only going to stick on the white polishes. That's the plan. I'm not too sure how it's going to go. So to apply these, I am going to be just using some of these like eyeshadow applicator sponge stuff. And that's what I'm going to use to apply the pigment. You can definitely go ahead and use a brush if you want, but I'm just going to use that. I just feel like it's going to help control it a little bit better. So we're going to go in with a yellow. We'll go in with the orange. They're so bright. Simon picking up on camera. It's crazy. We'll go in with the fluorescent green. Then we'll have a pink, I believe. Oh yeah, like a pink. And then we'll go in with maybe a purple. Yeah, I like that. So those are the combinations we're going to go with and hope it goes to plan. So let's start with the yellow. These are super, super messy to work with. So you do want to be careful of not getting it anywhere. So let's do that on the yellow, I mean on the pinky, and I'm hoping, you guys, I'm really hoping it works. So I feel like it might work, but there is a possibility that it won't. So let's go in with some of this yellow pigment and start. Okay, yeah, this definitely works. And we are going to start by placing that on our white. Wow, that looks really, really good, actually. I like that. So I'm just going to continue doing that for the rest of the nails very carefully, because this is a very fine pigment, and if I drop this, it is going to be a pain to clean. It's going to get everywhere. Okay, next let's do the orange. Alright, so once I have all of those on, I am going to go in and just take a brush and wipe off some of that pigment that's just on the glossy part. And it should wipe off quite easily just by brushing, which it definitely did. These look so nice. I'm obsessed with how they look. So I'm going to go in with a top coat now. I'm just going to use a different top coat this time, just because I don't want to contaminate my other top coat that I use on a regular basis. So I'm just going to take this and work that in and top coat our pigment in. All right, so once I have them cured, I am going to go in with some alcohol on just like some tissue, and I'm just gonna wipe underneath of them, just making sure. Oh yeah, oh my goodness. They are so clear. They're like crystal clear. Love that. That's exactly what we wanted. So I'm just going to grab some alcohol and wipe underneath my nails. Wow, these look so, so good. I'm actually quite impressed with how these look. Now I honestly really, really like the way that these nail tips fit and look. I think they look very nice. The only thing I'm noticing is that I am using some alcohol underneath, and as you can see, they are kind of like fogging up, and I'm not too sure how to, like this one, it was so crystal clear, and now using alcohol, as you can see, it has kind of fogged up the tip a little. So not too sure what we are going to do, but I will try to take just maybe like a dry bit and try my best to clean this up, and hopefully that works. But yeah, I guess it does work, but I'm gonna have to work a little bit harder now and get this cloudiness to go away. So the next thing I'm going to do now is grab some cuticle oil and really bring these to life, because my cuticles around these nails are so dry. Alright everyone, and that is all for this video. These are the nails that I created using the Beetles nail tips and glue set. I definitely will recommend this to you all who want a good Apres dupe. This was so good and so easy to use, definitely beginner friendly. If you did enjoy this video, do not forget to give it a thumbs up, and also do not forget to subscribe while you are at it. If you do want me to test out and review any other kits, definitely leave that in the comments down below as well. And I shall see you all in my next video. Bye!